CUSA this year. We are hope everyone enjoyed the food. It's decent, not too bad. It's very good. Welcome everyone in this very cold, not that cold, cold evening to join our CUSA culture and annual CUSA culture show. CUSA stands for Chinese Undergraduate Student Association, serves as a bridge between Chinese culture and UChicago campus. This quarter will also be an international food festival, and we'll have a Chinese New Year event. So stay tuned and be in our CUSA page on our Facebook, and if you like our events. Thank you very much.
Gordon, I love you!
So, everybody, at this moment, we would like to ask you to turn off your cell phones and all pagers, and refrain from any sort of photography of this role. And also, for the unlikely event of emergency, please take a moment to familiarize yourself with the emergency exit near you. When the show starts, please relax and enjoy the show, please. Thank you.
Thank you.
Boys, you're also goddamn stupid.
Don't say that.
Look what that douchebag did to Ying. Cheating on her, humiliating her, dumping her in public.
I really don't think she needs
to be. Next time I see that little butthead, I swear I'm gonna curse the ever living.
I'm sorry, Ying. I know you really liked him, but honestly, he wasn't worth your time. I think it's a good thing you two are separated now. But you know what? You'll find somebody a million times better, a billion times better. After all, fate always has its way of finding you your one true love.
What?
How about I get you some tea? How about chamomile? I know it's your favorite. Hey, Chen, come over here.
You need help with making tea?
Just come. I really think we should ask the master to reconsider.
What? What does that have to do with any of this?
Well, think about it. Ying is always getting involved with these stupid guys. It always ends in heartbreak. Instead of going, God damn it.
What? Did you not make him sound so freaking pathetic?
Okay, but you get my point. We could bring her to him. Think about it. You know he'd treat her well. You know he'd love her and they're destined to be together.
She's also destined to die.
Everyone dies eventually.
Whoa, that's awfully dark and out of character for you, man.
I know. It came out wrong.
No kidding.
But think about it. She would be happier. Happier than she's ever been. Happier than she ever will be with anyone else. Yes, that happiness will ultimately be kind of short-lived.
Short-lived is putting wildly, okay? She'll be dead. Dead before she even hits 25.
But have you ever considered that maybe, just maybe, that's better than the alternative? What does life have in store for her if she stays here? A lifetime of failed relationships, a lifetime of heartbreak. And it won't be because she's unlucky or because she's not trying hard enough, but because her soulmate is literally stuck 700 years in the past and we made it that way.
At least she won't die young.
Chan!
Guys, what's going on?
Hey! You are legally an adult. Now you're in college. You're old enough to, you know, to decide.
What?
Well, if you had to choose between living a shorter, painfully short life, which you could spend a very happy, a very brief time with the love of your life, only be separated by an early death, or you could live a very long life, full of pain and misery and heartbreak, and never find the one you truly love, what would you choose?
What?
Just answer, hon. And answer honestly. As if the rest of your life depends upon this one answer.
Yeah, you don't have to answer.
I think I would choose the short life.
Really?
Yes, I think I would.
Okay, great. I'll go some of them out.
Yeah, don't wait. I still don't know what's going on, guys.
I can't believe you just freaking summoned a master in front of Ying.
She already answered all my questions. She has the right to know and to decide.
Isn't that right?
Just ignore her. I mean, you can't just dump.
Hey, guys. Can someone please tell me what's going on?
Who is this?
Why did he suddenly appear out of nowhere in the middle of our apartment?
Ying, there's something we haven't told you. We're not exactly human.
Fairies and training to be exact.
And we were sent here to watch over you and to protect you.
And the master here, well, our master, is kind of like your fairy godmother, except,
dude. Fairies. You two are fairies, and he's a fairy godfather. Oh god, good one, guys. You're right, fairies.
We're not lying, you know.
Well, come on, I get it. This is all some elaborate joke just to cheer me up. Poor Ying, dumped once again by another guy, just needs to have a good laugh.
We're serious, Ying.
Well, come on, drop it. You guys always pull some weird prank on me every single time I get dumped, just to make me laugh.
Well, I laughed.
Ha! Huh. So we have to stop playing now. Seriously, just tell me.
Is this guy?
Allow me to explain. Many years ago, when I was still a novice myself, I was escaping from assassins sent by demonic fairy hunters. I was already gravely injured and desperately seeking shelter when a young woman, not much older than yourself, found me and hid me in her home. After the assassins left, she nursed me back to health and sent me back to my kin, with only my thanks as a measly repayment. I'll never forget her kindness and hospitality. Yet, because of this incident, once a demon cult discovered that she was the one who hid me and allowed me to escape, they poisoned her and cursed her infant daughter. Upon hearing this, I rushed to try to save her, but it was too late. On her deathbed, I promised the girl that I would do everything in my power to give her daughter a happy life, despite the curse that the demons had put on her. And when I saw that the fates dictated that her daughter have a short, tragic life, I searched for any means to try to change this fate, to find an alternative. And I did. I discovered that if I sent this infant 700 years into the future, she would be able to live a long life with the amenities of modernity to ease any sort of physical or emotional discomfort. However, I would be preventing her from finding her destined soulmate, and her life would be filled with the dissatisfaction of an unfulfilling love life. Yet, she would live.
That infant. The infant was me, wasn't it? That girl was my mother?
Your birth mother, from ancient China, the Jin Dynasty.
So that's why. That's what you two are talking about, right? The two alternative lives I could lead. And this whole fairies thing. Okay, just give me a second to process this all. I'm still not entirely convinced this isn't some sort of joke, but let's say I believe you. Then what? Clearly you guys have already been registered before me. We're in the 21st century, so I guess it's a long, unhappy life for me.
No, but see, that's the thing, Ying. It's not all set. You can still choose. In the other life, 18-year-old you is still alive. You can still go back. You can still meet him. I asked you before what kind of life you would prefer, remember?
You can't hold her to that. She didn't know the full story.
She knows the important parts.
I refuse to have my best friend, both of our best friends, die young.
Look, like I've said many times before, she has the right!
Both of you, enough! Min summoned me here to bring you back to ancient China. If that is what you desire, I can do it. It would be as though you always existed, from birth to adulthood. In that timeline, you will live out the rest of your life. But you must understand, once I do this, there's no coming back. It takes nearly too much magic to do this even twice in one lifetime. So choose wisely.
Ying, no matter what you choose, you know that we will still stand by and support you as your friends, right?
Look, I just want you to live a long and happy life. But yeah, we'll be there for you whatever you choose.
Thanks, man. I stand by what I said before. I choose a short life. I want to marry true love.
As you wish. You're awake.
I'm in ancient China?
Indeed.
But I still have my memories.
So you can remember the important decision you made. You also notice that taking the liberty of implanting some of the more important memories that someone in your position would be expected to remember.
Like the one where my father sent me to Confucian school to get a proper education.
Correct. Now here, you're a student, and you will address me as Master Z, and know me only as the headmaster of this school.
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, I have some business to attend to, so I'll leave you here. I'll send for another student around to show you. Oh, I almost forgot. Remember, you're a boy.
What?
Only boys are allowed to study.
Oh.
Good luck. Hey.
Oh, hi.
Are you the new student?
Yeah. Yep, that's me.
Have you got all your belongings into the living quarters yet?
Yeah, I think so.
And have you received your schedule?
Yep.
And my apologies, I haven't introduced myself yet. My name is Shan.
Hello. I'm Ying.
It is a pleasure to meet you.
Likewise.
Where does your family hail from?
Huang.
Oh, in the Jiangxi district. I've never been there myself, but I've heard of its wonderful gardens.
Yep. That's the one.
My hometown was also renowned for its beautiful mountain scenery. Or at least it used to be.
I'm sure it's still quite nice there.
Well, like many places in the area, it's had countless issues in recovering from the war. I hope to earn a government position after my studies here, so I can be placed back home. Though I may not be able to do much, I want to contribute at least a little bit for my family and friends. My apologies. Enough about myself. What about you? What are you aiming to do?
Well, I originally wanted to be a doctor, but medicine these days is kind of sketch.
Pardon?
What?
You just called medicine sketch?
Oh, that's just a part of the battle from where I live. I'm so sorry.
No, don't apologize. It's just, I've never met anyone else who speaks like this before.
Truly, I myself have heard many of people speak with my particular set of vocabulary. And in all other aspects, I like to defend myself by saying that I believe, good sir, that I speak in a manner quite suitable for a normal daily conversation.
I see what you're doing.
What do you mean by that?
Don't be embarrassed by how you speak. It was different, but not in a bad way, and I believe retaining a hometown dialect is a good thing. It's like a connection at home. And in any case, I find it so endearing that you speak so informally. It's as if we're already friends. I'm sorry, have I embarrassed you?
No, you're fine.
How about I make it up to you? Just 20 minutes away, there's a garden. And it's probably not as beautiful as the garden in Jinghua, but it's where I go when I need to get away from my studies. And I would love to take you.
That would be great.
Alright, I have a meeting with Master Z soon, so I'll see myself out.
Wait!
Is something the matter?
Are you going to show me around?
I'd love to, but I have an appointment soon.
Weren't you the student Master Z sent to show me around?
Oh no, I came here because I heard that the new student, well, you, had fallen ill on the way here and ended up in the infirmary. But you seem to be doing fine, yes?
Oh, yes, I'm good. Thanks for asking. I guess you should go then.
I do need to be going. But the garden, don't forget, come find me when you would like to go.
Will do.
And I look forward to seeing you in class tomorrow.
Well, that was freaking adorable. What are you thinking? How are you feeling?
Man, calm down.
Oh my god, it was meant to be. I always knew it.
Breathe.
But, yeah, what did you think of
thought he was nice. Really nice.
And cute.
Yeah.
I mean,
he lied to us, you know, so don't try to deny it.
Yeah, I guess.
Wait, what are you guys doing here anyways? Aren't you guys supposed to be off doing magical things or whatever?
And leave you here alone?
With that douche.
What I meant was, what kind of best friend slash guardfairies would we be if we left you alone in this other country 700 years in the past? So, we'll be students here, just like you.
Yeah, besides, who's going to be your school tour guide if we weren't alone?
So, you two were the students in my master's seat?
Oh, hell yeah. Although, you was wrong with half Sean instead, am I right?
That's not true. Not even a teensy bit? Come on, we've got what's more to show you!
was such a beautiful performance.
Well, I guess, if you're into that kind of stuff.
Oh, come on, don't be like that.
I agree with Min, it was quite nice.
I do as well. Lee, what did you think of the performance?
Oh, the dancers are great. Every single one of them.
Every single one of them? I, for one, saw that you only had eyes for the girl in pink.
Nonsense. Perhaps your eyes are going bad, Sean.
Do not make excuses, Lee. Everyone knows that out of all people, you're the most interested in looking at pretty girls. Am I not right?
Shall we talk about something else? How about those Confucius readings?
Oh, shush, Lee. Don't interrupt the conversation. You're nothing if not obsessed with girls, so don't you dare try and pretend you're more interested in your studies than those gorgeous dancers from before.
You're all like themselves.
Don't worry. I actually know that dancer. I'd be happy to introduce you.
Wait, will you really?
Of course. All right, let's go.
Chun, come with us.
Why? I want to meet some random dancer.
Come on, man. You don't have to make her go.
Bye.
Those two are just two medals for their own good.
Would you like any tea?
Sure.
You know what is unbelievable? That it's been two full years since you joined us for the day.
Wow. Has it really? I can't believe you still remember. Your memory is amazing, as always.
Well, it was you who Master Z praised for memorizing the entirety of the analyze.
No.
There's no need to be modest in front of me.
I guess.
In any case, as I was saying, I've been meaning to ask you something.
Are you alright?
Yes, well, I would just like to say that we've been such close friends, best friends even, and I would like to continue our friendship for... Would you like to become my sworn brother?
Oh, God. Want to take the oath of brotherhood?
Yes.
Me?
Who else could it be?
Are you sure?
Yes, and I'm positive. However, if you do not want to, then...
No, I do. I mean, of course I do. I'd love to go with a brotherhood with you, but... Why me? I mean, you know Lee for so much longer, I just don't understand.
You may have known Lee for longer, but I've been closer with you. You're one of the best people I've ever met, and I have no idea what good deed I did to deserve your friendship. You're intelligent, kind, and humorous. And above all, a great friend to me and to everyone, and I sincerely hope we can continue our friendship for a long time, if not for the rest of our lives. So what do you say? Will you take the oath with me?
Yes, of course.
I was so worried you were about to reject me. We'll be bound by oath for life. That means you will never, ever be rid of me again. Well, I better be able to do the reading next year. We'll do the oath sometime. Don't you dare forget.
I wouldn't dream of it.
Then I will see you at dinner.
Yay!
Holy! How did you get in here? There's no door there.
Well, you keep forgetting that we're magic. So we just came in through the ceiling.
Alright, whatever.
Were you two eavesdropping again?
No.
Fine. Yes, we were eavesdropping.
Guy.
But it was so cute. His speech was so sweet.
Oh yeah. If I didn't know any better, I would have thought he was about to get down on me and propose.
Oh, I wish. Oh, come on, guys. He still thinks I'm a guy.
Oh. I don't know. That kid acts like he's tapping with you despite the fact that you're a dude.
You two spent enough time together to be a couple anyway.
Stop it, guys. Seriously.
Is everything alright?
Yeah, I guess. I wish I'd tell the truth, you know, that I'm a girl. Then maybe we could be a real couple. But I can't just drop that kind of bomb on you. Anyway. If anyone found out I was a girl here, I'd be kicked out.
I'm sorry. But I'm sure that if you told him, he'd keep your secrets.
Yeah. Still, it's kind of a risky to have a secret relationship in this kind of place anyway. And I don't know if you could ever see me as anything other than a good friend, like a brother.
Well, guess you've been brothers on.
No, she's right. I don't know if you could ever love me like that. You've only ever seen me as a boy.
Well, Ying, have some faith. I mean, after all, what else would we bring you down here for except to meet him? You want your love, remember?
Right.
Well, answer me this one question. Do you love him?
Yes.
I think he loves you too. But I mean, this being ancient China, he probably can't even consider the notion of loving another so-called god, but I can tell he's very, very attached to you.
I suppose.
And I figure, no matter what you decide in the end, things will work out.
Yeah. Hey, we're your family guardian being things. You should really believe in what we say more.
Yeah, all right. Come on, guys. Let's go to dinner.
Oh, I almost forgot. A messenger came with this letter for you. It's from your father. Here, take a look.
Oh no.
What is it?
My father, he wants me to head home. As soon as the term is over next week.
Well, that's pretty normal though.
No, he says 2 years is sufficient education for a girl. And he wants me to go home. Permanently.
What?
Yeah, damn it. What am I gonna tell son? How am I gonna tell him? We just agreed to swear the oath of brotherhood and have to leave forever with no real explanation. And I'm already 20 now, and Sen's still got years more of school to go. What if I die before I see him again? Am I never gonna see him again? Should I tell my girl then? And that I love him? What do I do?
Ying, calm down. We don't know that yet, and as for what to do, we still have time to decide, right?
Right.
But for right now, really need to calm down because we're about to go to dinner and you cannot break down in front of everyone.
Okay. I'll talk later.
Here.
Thanks.
We'll have to go soon, or else we'll be late.
Alright.
You ready to go?
Okay, let's go.
Just one hour. That's all the time I have left to spend with Sun before I have to leave school forever. This week has been simultaneously the most wonderful and most excruciating we've ever experienced. Every day, Sun and I come up with something new and exciting to do together. Yet, I couldn't help but think about this time limit that we have. Every day I would wake up and think, 6 more days, 5 more days. 4, 3, 2, 1. Until today, the last day. I know what you're thinking. I'm being overdramatic about this whole thing. It's not like this is the last time that I'll see him again, right? But it really might be. I know I'm about to die before I turn 25, so who knows? Maybe I'll never, ever see him again. That really scares me. Maybe he'll never know that I love him. And maybe it's better that way. But I still feel like he deserves to know the truth about my gender. I'm too scared to tell him directly, but maybe if he figures it out himself, it won't be so bad. At least that's what I'm telling myself. In any case, I've been prepared. Hopefully he'll notice this time.
My apologies for being late. I'll get us in the necessary items.
Sir, I've got a question for you.
Yes?
Do I look any different to you today?
Different?
Yeah. Doesn't my appearance look more enhanced than usual?
Now that you mention it, I see you wearing lipstick.
Yes, yes. In my hair?
That's a beautiful accessory. In any case, I was gathering items for a ceremony.
Don't you find that weird?
No.
But in this day and age, only girls wear makeup and sparkly hair accessories.
That is usually the case, yes.
So?
I believe everyone's entitled to their own likes and dislikes. And I'm in no place to judge other people, especially not my friends. Although, I would caution you against wearing those in public. With your small stature and fair skin, you could actually be mistaken for a girl.
So you think I look like a girl?
Only occasionally. But do not worry, I've seen other men who appear much girlier than you.
Don't know whether to be pleased or offended. Alright, I've got another question.
Yes?
Don't you think that our bond is so special? Like two peas in a pod or a pair of butterflies?
You're right, I suppose. Two peas in a pod.
Butterflies.
You insist, except butterflies refer to
a romantic relationship between a boy and a girl.
Which we are not, so I don't think it's an apt comparison.
Right.
But I'm glad you bring that up.
What?
Like you said, our bond is special. I hope you haven't forgotten that you agreed to be my sworn brother.
Of course not.
And now that you're leaving, are you ready to take the oath?
What?
I have a ceremony of wine. We can do the oath right now.
Oh, wow. I haven't even written out what I wanted to say yet.
I have a traditional oath prescribed right here.
Alright, let's do it now.
We will rescue
each other in difficulty.
We will aid each other in danger. We ask not the same day of birth, but we seek to live a long life as kin, to bring death together.
May the gods of heaven and earth attest to what is in our hearts.
If ever we were to betray our friendship,
may heaven and man strike us dead.
I definitely like to marry her.
So, is there such a person then? A girl version of you?
No.
Don't say you lied. Who is it?
It's my sister.
Sister?
Yeah, I have a sister. She's 1 year younger than us. She's exactly like me.
All right then, it's settled. I'll have to meet your sister then.
What?
You already said she's exactly like you, but a girl. And I already said I would like to marry a girl version of you, so wouldn't it make sense that I meet a girl that I may want to marry?
Right.
Then I will come to your town to call your sister.
No, no.
Why not?
It would be too selfish of me to come ask you to marry my sister.
Well, Ying, I'll obtain permission from your entire family.
That's not what I mean.
Ying, then what do you mean? If I marry your sister, we'll really be family. We'll be real brothers, and if I get a job in the city, then we can perhaps see each other almost every day.
Yes. No, Shan. The thing is, my sister, she's really sick. She may not even live for many more years. So although nothing would make me happier than for you to marry my sister, I wouldn't want to burden you like that.
It wouldn't be a burden to me. Even if it was just a month, a week, or a day, it would be worth it.
Really?
Of course. So what do you say?
Alright.
I, Liang Shanbo, swear to the heavens that I will come to court your sister as soon as I'm done with my studies. All parties are willing.
Then, here. As a token of your promise.
I'll guard it with my life. And here, this handkerchief.
For my sister?
No, for you. Don't forget, we're sworn brothers now.
Hey, Ying! Get
out of here! It's time to go! That was
Nin. Yes, it was.
I really miss you.
I'll miss you as well.
Promise me you'll write?
As often as I can. Only temporarily. I have a promise I need to keep. Remember?
Right.
Ying!
Oh, I'll see you later.
Silly girl. Shan, why was it a good idea not to tell him to come and fetch us in the city?
Because this is supposed to be a surprise for him.
Why was that necessary? We've never set foot in this city before. How are we supposed to find this house?
Don't be so pessimistic, Lee. Besides, we're going to be working here from now on. Don't we at least attempt to navigate the city?
Yeah, we should. But perhaps with the tour guide. A friendly, perfectly willing tour guide. Such a thing.
Somebody.
Easy words coming from a man who's about to go meet and marry Ying's beautiful sister. It's but natural that you're so eager to do something romantic like surprise them.
Say what you want, Lee. I'll not be dissuaded.
And what if we showed up in his house and there's no one home? Or even worse, what if he doesn't even recognize us?
Don't be ridiculous. It's only been a year and a half.
Well then, even more so. You wouldn't be expecting that we finish our studies a full year early.
I am confident that you will be able to recognize this man. Not sure about you though. I've seen you go a couple sizes for your robe. And get us to know that a few pounds will really change the look of a man.
Why would they recognize me? I look exactly the...
Wait, are you calling me fat? I'm just kidding.
Ha, very amusing.
Indeed. And besides, I've got this betrothal necklace from... sister.
Wait, do you see that? I think that's our hotel. Let's go.
Can you take this? I want to have a look around the corner. I think Ying said his home was around here somewhere.
Alright, suit yourself. I'm going upstairs for a rest.
Must be around here somewhere. Better ask for directions. Excuse me, miss. Miss? Miss, are you alright? Are you Ying?
I'm not Ying. I'm Ying's sister.
Are you feeling well?
Yes, quite. And who are you?
I am one of your brother's classmates.
Oh, I see. Well, Ying's not home right now, so you should just go.
I can wait.
No, he won't be home for a really long time, so you should really
wait. Ying, stop right there.
Shan, I told you, I'm not Ying.
Then how do you know my name? I never said I was Shan. I always said I was your brother's classmate.
Ying told me that one of his classmates promised me my suitor. He told me your name. It was a reasonable guess.
Alright then, what about the handkerchief? I gave that to Ying, to you.
You gave to him as a token of your promise to come marry me.
No, I explicitly told him, you, that it was a token of our promise as sworn brothers.
Well, maybe he forgot.
Enough, Ying. Stop making excuses. I know it's you. You look the same. You sound the same. You're even wearing the same hair as the day that you left. I'll recognize you, even if we hadn't seen each other in a lifetime. It's good to see you, Ying.
But are you mad at me? I've kept such a huge secret from you.
Silly girl, we've been together at school for such a long time. Do you think I would not have noticed if something was strange? You're also not the best actor.
Well, what about that last day? I was trying so hard to sell you into that as a girl, and yet you seemed to get it.
Oh, I got it. And it was not subtle in the least, but at least it was quite amazing.
Were you just toying with me then?
No. No, I figured that you must have had a good reason for not wanting to tell me in the first place, and I don't want to push anything you weren't ready for. That's why I kept quiet.
Well, what about that last day? You said I wasn't being subtle about it at all.
Well, I figured that you must have had a good reason not wanting to tell me, and you were probably feeling hesitant about it in the first place, but you couldn't leave it completely alone either. Am I wrong?
No. Well, what about everything else? The oath of brotherhood? The promise to marry my sister?
Oh, I brought it up because even if you were never to reveal our identity to me, I still would have liked to have a connection with you. And if we had a play at being brothers for the rest of our lives, I would be okay with that. At least, that's what I told myself at the time. But this past year and a half, being without you, I realized I can bear it no longer, and though you may not be able to... I know you don't have a sister, Ying. I've always known that part was a lie. But my promise was still real, Ying. I still want to marry into your family. I want to marry you. What do you say then? Will you marry me?
Yes, I would love to.
I do have one question for you, Young. Mm-hmm. When you proposed the idea of marriage, were you pretending on being your own sister for everybody?
I don't know, I didn't really think it through. I just knew I wanted to give you my life, somehow. I was desperate for that. But I just didn't want to go any further.
Well, Ying, everything's all cleared up now. You never have to hide anything from me again.
Right.
Ying, is something the matter?
I have to tell you something.
Sean, where are you?
Oh, that must be Lee. This is perfect. I have some gifts for your father, and I'll get them right back.
Wait, what? Why?
You can't think that I'm so rude as to ask for your hand in marriage without betrothal gifts, right? Wait for me. I will be back in a few minutes.
What? What are you doing here?
Who was that man you were talking to?
That's none of your
business. It's my business. I'm in New York.
No. No, you're not. I haven't agreed to it yet.
Ying, it is not your place to decide whether or not you want them. Your father already did. And that is all that matters.
Who cares? Leave me alone. Let go of me!
Stop!
Don't touch her! Who are you?
I can ask the same about you.
Hi, I'm Shan, Ying's classmate from school.
Oh, Shan, I'm Wen. And might I ask, what were you doing earlier? Just classmates. There would be no reason for you to get so close.
I was asking for a hand in marriage.
Unfortunately for you, Shan, I am already her fiancé.
Ying, is that true?
No, no. I told you, I refuse to accept it.
That's what father already did.
I don't care what he says, I won't do it.
Will you really betray your father, Ying? Will you really? Betray the man who single-handedly raised you? He's taking the adult's way out of poverty for you? His only family left, the man allowed to go to school, despite your merely a girl? Would you really do that, Ying? Are you so heartless? What's all this emotion? Sir, this rascal here can take away your daughter. What?
No, father, don't listen to him.
Explain to me, Ying, what is going on, sir?
My name is Shan, and I was Ying's classmate at school, and ever since the first moment I met her, I felt a strong connection, and after this past year and a half of being without her, I realized that I love her and truly cannot live without her. I promise I can and will provide for her and protect her for the rest of our lives together. So, sir, I would be immensely grateful if you would allow me to marry your daughter.
Young man, you seem like a nice child, but I've already promised her to this man when...
But father, I don't want to marry him. I don't love him.
Quiet, Ying. Preparations for the wedding have already begun.
It's not too late to back out yet.
Promises made must be kept. I will not be backing out of this arrangement. In any case, I'm sure that Wen will be able to provide comes from a good, wealthy family. Whereas this boy here, he is no more than a poor scholar.
For now, but soon he'll become a city official. And even still, father, I don't care about living a wealthy lifestyle.
No, Ying, you're marrying Wen and that is final.
Please, father, please let me be with Shan. I love him. Even if I won't have the newest clothes, or the nicest carriage, at least I'd be with the man that I love. At least I'd be happy. So please, father, please let me marry Shan.
Sorry, Ying, but love would not put food on the table when times are hard. I would not relent.
Father, why won't you let me choose? Do you hate me so much? Do you not want me to be happy?
How many girls are raised and then allowed to choose who they marry? How many, Ying? entire life except you. It was difficult for you without your mother. I allowed you to go to school, disguised as a boy, and has allowed you to do as you wish. But no longer. You're a grown woman, a member of formal society, and you will act as such by obeying your father and marrying Wen.
And if I say no?
Then you're no daughter of mine.
Sir, wait. Sir. I will not come between Ying and the only family she has left. And I will not allow her to make that kind of difficult decision. And you're right, sir. Promises made must be kept. So here, I will draw my proposal. Take my leave.
No, no, you don't have to do this!
I do. Here.
No, Shan, please don't go. Please don't leave me. I love you.
Shan, I brought the controller case. What's going on?
Shan.
I love you too.
What?
Come on, Lee, we need to go. They're saying that he most likely won't last the night.
What?
I've got to go send a letter to his parents, but I've left his back door open, so you can go see him. One last time.
Thank you, Lee. He's going to die. But you guys never put him in. I mean, you guys would have said something on the case, right? Are you guys fairies? Can you guys somehow magically make him get better?
Ying, our hats are tied. Ever since the High Council discovered that the Master sent you both forward, at backward in time, his magic has been temporarily sealed, and we are both under oath to never again affect the fates of living humans. We can no longer say or do anything about that anymore.
No. There's no one who'll die.
Ying,
I gotta go.
Ying, wait! Isn't there anything we can do? You do know what happens after he dies, right?
No, since she chose to come back here, nothing in the world can save either of them.
I know.
wouldn't have wanted me to do this. And I tried my hardest to live on, to move on, because I know that's what you would want for me. I couldn't. Shan, I hope you know how important you are to me. Without you in my life, no. Without the knowledge of you living somewhere, somehow, I can't bear it. I've always been told to follow my heart. Well, my heart is with you. I'm not ready to follow it. Even if it means following it into the next life.
No. I'm so stupid. Of course she'd be here. I can't believe I didn't think to...
There's still one thing you can do.
What is it?
My magic seal, but yours isn't.
But we're in a role.
To refrain from affecting the lives of living humans. But they're both dead.
Exactly, so what can we even do?
Their souls.
You know what you must do.
Your souls remain entwined for the rest of eternity.
Okay. Hi everyone, I hope you really enjoyed the show. My name is Iris, and as some of you might know, I am the writer and one of the co-directors for this year's CUSA show. Wow, this is the first time that I've ever actually sat down and watched the show. Normally I'm backstage yelling at people, but that was super nerve-wracking, not being able to do anything, but you guys are really good, so I'm glad. Last year when we started planning for the show, I never imagined that I would be the one who ended up in charge. I have no real directing or scriptwriting experience, so I just kind of jumped right in and sold my soul to the show, basically, and like died a little bit in the middle. But it was all worth it, because everyone did so well, and for that, I have to thank every person standing on the stage right now, because each and every one of them were hardworking and enthusiastic in their own way, and it was an absolute joy working with all of you. So, to the actors, thank you for putting up with all my long rehearsals and my inexperience as a director. I truly hope that you enjoyed acting in this production, because I know that I really enjoyed watching you guys bring my words to life. Honestly, that turned out more like a K-drama than I thought it would be. To Sharon, Tommy, Tori, Alex, Kevin, Ray, and Ryan, Richard, you guys all did wonderfully good job. You guys over there. Okay, more or less. Thank you. Thank you guys for putting in all the hours for the dance rehearsal, even though they were sometimes really, really disorganized. Despite the fact that many of us are amateurs, and I think a lot of us have never performed on stage before, we managed to put on, would you believe it, a 7.5-minute full dance set. So, good job, guys. Many of you, but just know that I'm proud of all of you. To the traditional dancers, martial artists, and the string quartet, although I could not personally be at all of your rehearsals the way I was for these guys, because I was for some reason in charge of them, I really appreciate all your cooperation, and I think you all did a really amazing job. For the traditional dancers, I would particularly like to thank Dormy. Where is she? I don't know if you guys caught that line, but anyways. She was both the lead dancer and one of the best dance teachers we could have ever hoped to have. So thank you so much, Dormy. To the backstage crew, upstairs in the booth, behind the scenes, and to the Mandel staff, thank you for doing this ever so important job. Although we never see you during the actual performance, I mean, except for when you could kind of see when the lights are out and they're scrambling back and forth, that was that. Except for that, I just wanted you guys all to know that we really appreciate the effort you all put into making this show run smoothly. So, Calvin, Wendy, both Sarahs, both Sylvias, Michelle, Wiley, honestly, the list goes on, but seriously, thank you all. Very good. For taking the time out of all your busy schedules to come out and watch our beloved production, I can only express words of gratitude. Thank you so much. I really hope you guys all enjoyed the CUSA show this year. Thank you. Well, I didn't have a closing statement.
Thanks everyone for coming tonight. Hope you really enjoyed the show and have a great evening.
A lot of trouble for her for like not knowing my lines until the last minute, things like that, but she really was wonderful, and I really like the script, and I just want to say thank you one more time.
Thank you for looking after the show and taking care of me as your flatmate.